afternoon, board members and colleagues, staff. The time is 1:02 p.m. on this, the 30th day of June, 2021, and I call this meeting of the Laredo College Board of Trustees to order. May I have Mr. Delgado say the prayer, please?
Yes, Madam Chair. Thank you. Heavenly Father, we come to you today asking for your guidance, wisdom, and support as we begin this meeting. Help us to engage in meaningful discussion, allow us to grow closer as a group, and nurture the bonds of our amazing community. Fill us with your grace, Lord God, as we make decisions that might affect the students, staff, faculty, alumni, and friends of Laredo College. And continue to remind us that all that we do here today, all that we accomplish is for the pursuit of the truth and service for this amazing community. Amen.
Amen. Judge, pledge your allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Ramos, could you please call roll?
Thank you. Lupita Cepeda?
Present.
Jorge J.D. Delgado?
Present.
Jackie Levin Ramos, present. Cynthia Mares? She's present on Zoom.
She's present on Zoom.
Mercurio Martinez Jr.?
Present.
Henry Carranza?
Present.
Esteban Rangel?
Present.
Karina Lizondo?
She's present.
Thank you. Tita Cantuvela? Ma'am, you have a quorum?
Thank you. Let the record show that a quorum of board members is present, that this meeting has been duly called, and that notice of this meeting has been posted in accordance with the Texas Open Meetings Act. The next item I have is public testimony. Mr. Gonzalez.
Thank you, Madam Chair, members of the board. Michael Gonzalez, Senior Director of External Affairs. For the record, we do have one for public comment this afternoon.
Thank you. And let me just read on the public comment. An individual's comments to the board shall not exceed 3 minutes per meeting. When there are six or less speakers scheduled, the board president may extend each speaker's time to 5 minutes. Time may not be ceded from one speaker to another. The board president may also limit the total amount of time for public testimony, but not to less than 30 minutes. The speaker may not speak on personnel or student matters that refer to individuals by name or title. After a speaker's comment, the board president shall make whatever response, if any, or take whatever action, if any, is deemed appropriate to handle the matter. Such response or action may include the following: referring the matter to the college president for action or for further recommendations, referring the matter to a later meeting or to a board committee for further discussion or study, indicating that the matter shall be taken under advisement. If the board president determines that a person has not attempted to resolve a matter administratively, the person shall be directed to the appropriate policy for attempted resolution before bringing the matter to the board. Thank you.
Good afternoon, distinguished members of the board. My name is Dr. Teo Pinoche, and I'm going to make my comments very brief. They're just about roasting some of the accomplishments of the president. One of the things that he did when he first came in was to negotiate external funding leases on the campus. We have a state patrol that are leasing some of our buildings. Some fell through due to the pandemic. He also took care of additional parking spaces where the students were parking, where the faculty were. He negotiated with the Army Reserves, and we have a parking right there in front of LIAC. We had a problem with the one-way street where students were rushing down that. He immediately changed it to the two-way. He got rid of the nurse. We used to have a permanent nurse on campus. And he said, you know what? Instead of having the permanent nurse where the students don't go, let's establish the gateway, which we all saw yesterday, and have that for the community and the students. So he went ahead and did that. We won the TikTok, the $1 million prize under his leadership. He also gave us a 5% raise. Mike, I came from Georgia State University, taught graduate school. Two of my colleagues when I was doing my PhD are presidents, and they weren't able to give raises. They were not able to bring external funding. The president was able to do that. He also changed the library, the executive library, into a money-making machine, so to speak, where before the pandemic, it was continually bringing in funds where people were occupying that. And that's all I've got to say. I hope that was appropriate. Thank you for listening to my roast of the president. Thank you, distinguished members of the board.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The next item that I have on the discussion and possibly action, accepting the resignation of the college president. And I'm going to read the letter. Dated June 30th, 2021. Dear Laredo College Board of Trustees, after five remarkable years of presidential service and pursuant to our recent discussion, I hereby submit my resignation and separation from the presidency of Laredo College effective August 31st, 2021. However, I plan to only remain active in my presidential role through July 15th for the purpose of fulfilling established goals and strategic plans, assisting in every possible manner with a smooth transition with the new LC interim president. Thereby, I will be utilizing my earned and documented accrued vacation time during my period of absence while not returning, including up to the remainder of my official separation of August 31st. During my vacation period, if the board president or interim president requests my assistance, I will unquestionably make myself available. Leading Laredo College has been an extraordinary and transformational experience. I feel privileged to have been a part of such a professional college team and will immensely miss all my colleagues. Certainly, I take this opportunity to convey to you, the Laredo College Board of Trustees, how pleased I am to have served as the CEO of one of the most responsive, innovative, and the top-ranked community college in Texas. I look forward to continuing this relationship for many years to come. With appreciation and best wishes, I am sincerely Dr. Ricardo J. Solis, President.
Madam Chair.
Is there a motion?
I'd like to make a motion, but we fortunately and reluctantly accept his resignation.
So I have a motion from Judge Martinez. I have a second from Mr. Delgado. Do I have any discussion? He doesn't have his hand raised.
No, he's not.
Yeah. Any discussion? Okay. From Ms. Mares or Ms. Elizondo?
No, I'm fine. I'm in favor. I'm fine.
Okay. So, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you, Dr. Solis.
Thank you.
For everything that you've done for our college.
Madam Chair.
Yes, I recognize Mr. Rangel.
Yes, Dr. Solis, thank you. Wish you the very, very best. I liked the fact of the conversation that me and you had, which was we'll remain as friends. So I extend, again, my friendship towards you on anything we could do, you know, and I appreciate everything you did for the college. It was short-lived, you know, with I guess, us three short ones, newer ones, but still, thank you so much. Did very well, and I'm proud, and wish you the very, very best in your endeavors. Thank you.
Chair recognizes Mrs. Ramos.
Dr. Solis, it's not goodbye, but until we see each other again. Thank you for the experience, and thank you for coming to Laredo. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Anyone else?
Chair recognizes.
Yes, I have Dr. Carranza first, and then you'll be next, Ms. Elizondo.
Perfect. Thank you.
All I want to say is thank you for your great job you've done with the college and promoted us to number one in the state. And which means that we're the number one. We're number one also, you know, so in a way, you know, is that we hate to see you go, but there's always, we always, like any other positions, you train for those positions, you do well, and sometimes doors open where you have to go take a look at it. And I wish you all the luck and endeavors in your new job. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Carranza. Chair recognizes Ms. Elizondo.
Dr. Solis, I just wanted to say thank you so much for everything you have done for the college. Even though I have been with the board a couple of months, I'm able to recognize all your hard work, and thank you for bringing a lot of prestige to the college. Thank you for all of those endless nights that you worked very hard for, not only the college, but the staff and administration and the faculty and our students. Thank you so much for everything.
Thank you, Ms. Elizondo. Chair recognizes Mr. Delgado.
Yep. I'll make it short, but we want to make it a somber moment, but definitely grateful, Dr. Solis, for definitely your guidance and your leadership, especially from faculty and the staff and everything that you've been able to accomplish in these short 5 years. You know, echoing the sentiments of what's already been said, it's definitely been a short year, short couple of years since we've been here, but we're definitely grateful for everything that you've done. And just like Trustee Ramos said, it's definitely not goodbye. We'll definitely see you again. Thankfully, you're just down the road, and look forward to that. So thank you for everything.
Anyone else? Thank you again, Dr. Solis, for everything that you did. Did you want to say something?
Certainly.
Chair recognizes Dr. Solis.
Of course, I was not going to go since we have time. I know I already gave my thanks and remarks at the last board meeting, saying that was my last official board meeting. And I just wanted to, again, reemphasize what everybody's saying here. I really appreciate your comments and your support throughout these 5 years. They've been phenomenal years, my best years ever, and most one that I dedicated the most of my life. And I'm glad and proud to say that when I came here 5 years ago exactly, that I leave the college in a much better situation, much better place than it is. That's what I take pride in. And more importantly, the community. The community has taken note. After the long pandemic absence, it was clear yesterday's event was a testament of the community. It wasn't just about the health program, it was about the college in general. And more importantly, it was about how we have been able to resonate success in the community. The people in the community had noted that. I'm totally blessed, and we are touched, Sylvia and I, by everybody in the community has been asking for dinner, lunch, breakfast, including this morning, to have for us, people that I didn't expect. And that is so touching, because they really like to see what the college has done. They've seen the college at a different light, and it means so much. And secondly, I know I won't go into details, but I know there was a lot of highlights, just like the surprise of Faculty Senate, Dr. Dayo came up today. I didn't expect that. I know that we definitely changed, and that was thanks to the administration, the relationship with faculty and with staff, and how everybody has come together and has been able to be able to cooperate and collaborate. And so all of these accolades, all these accomplishments, all these rankings, all of these from the accreditation to the new programs that we developed, that was done because we worked in unison with the staff, and of course, especially this esteemed administration, and especially, of course, with faculty. And everybody has been able to transform, to turn around all these different groups, where before when I came here, I found out they had not worked together. And all that changed on its own. I just set the tone, and everybody else just did what they had to do from every department. I won't go into detail, because I'll be here forever changing. I think we already talked about from the changing of the name to the logo to the colors, to more importantly, just the image of the college. That was the first thing. Then secondly, our charge to go into more entrepreneurial and transforming the college, our biggest accomplishments with, as he alluded to earlier, with the different organizations, beginning like with the U.S. Custom Brokers, that was just the beginning. That was 4 years ago. And that brought up many other opportunities with the federal government, and then the city took note, and then all the other agencies had taken note. We are very, very fortunate that we have a college that has the incredible assets and facilities. And I worked at five different institutions in my short career in higher education, and I visited easily over half of the colleges in Texas. Not one college comes near to the incredible assets that we have here, buildings and facilities, not only historical campus, but on the border, but facilities that are available to open up other opportunities. These other colleges dream and talk about those because they're at capacity, including the college that I'm about to, the system that I'm going to in the Valley. And we are here, our opportunities are limited, unlimited. We have so many opportunities here with so many empty buildings that we can take advantage of. And I'm so glad that the board was very supportive when I came here to not only reorganize, but restructure our funding, our bonds that we had. And thanks to the board and how you immediately took note of how important that was to reallocate those funds for other projects, from beginning from the library, how we turn it in to not a library, but to a multi-use facility. And then canceling all these other projects that were not necessary. I won't go into details, but that provided us a lot more funds to do other projects, infrastructure, roofing, air conditions, and of course, in the South Campus, many other facilities now that we're about to embark on the biggest one ever, and that's gonna be our expansion. In addition to the health, of course, the expansion of our transportation. That's gonna really resonate with opportunities for Laredo. The transportation facilities, that's gonna, everybody's excited about that, the private sector. And I'm so glad the board immediately saw that as an opportunity and we reallocated those funds. On top of that, we're still gonna have $15 million left over to do other projects. And I really hope that that we continue with working with these multi-use, very visionary projects with the state and the federal government and other entities, because the college is to transform. We can't go backwards. And again, I wanted to now on the personal level, thank the board for supporting me in all these endeavors. Specifically, I know I don't want to go into detailed name, but when I first came here, I'll never forget the calls, the support that I got from most of the board members with support and insights and recommendation. Dr. Carranza, I really appreciate your daily calls for the past 3 years. They've been very helpful in providing me, of course, with support and confidence. But most importantly, I won't go into other, because I know all of you have called me numerous times every week for the past 3 years, 4 years, with a lot of information and insight and support, which is what the board is supposed to do, and you certainly have. But here with Judge Mercurio, he was the chair, president of the board for my first 4 years, 4.5 years, I guess. And I want to thank you for, from day one, even before I arrived here, he was already contacting me to set up meetings with the various constituents and organizations in Laredo. And that was incredibly valuable for me. And for that, I'm very, very grateful for you to allow that. And not only that, but on the day, my first 6 months, he was here daily in my office to make sure that if anything I needed, and he would take me to the people to make sure that I got to meet him. That was invaluable. For that, I wanted to thank you, Judge McQuitty, for providing me that support. And I hope that continues with the next president. Challenge. It is incredibly important that you support and provide that type of insight and support and respect to the next president, because it's lonely on the top when you're working 24/7. And then now on the other hand, I want to mention, of course, my staff. You all have been incredibly, I know, part of this success. And I know that there's not enough credit out there to give you for everything that you've done, beginning with Dr. Fred, incredible what you've done. Cesar, and helping with the finances and keeping that going. And of course, Dr. Arasola, and taking charge of these new ventures that people have taken note of. Yesterday I mentioned all those accolades. And of course, most importantly, with Dr. Maricela, and the academics. So I didn't need to tell you what to do, because y'all knew what to do. Y'all did it on your own. And I just set the pace, and thanks for all of you, what you've done. And of course, Mr. Ramon, for helping us with the technology to keep on forward. I didn't have to tell him what to do. And of course, Michael, I know you're new, but you're doing a great job with that. And Adriana, in the South Campus, taking over the big shoes of Carolyn. Incredible. The South Campus is gonna be our big North Star of success, no, undoubtedly. And the librarian, of course, what a successful story. And everybody, of course, Albert, with the dual credits, now we're out the roof. I think we're one of the highest dual credit percentages in the state. And so, that's a big task to continue. But overall, all of you have been incredibly, and I'm grateful for everything that you've done. I would never have done this without me, and I know that sometimes I'm given the credit when I know it's not due, but I think everybody knows that somebody has to take charge and get the credit, but we know that it's always behind the president, that without people, the followers, I wouldn't be receiving these recognitions like I did yesterday. So I'm definitely recognize that. So everybody in the staff has been incredible. Of course, Rusty, with the legal matters, you've been also every weekly calls. I don't think we went without a week without talking. But all of these insights from you and support have been invaluable. And I thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. And back to your comments about working, continuing, partnering. I mentioned that yesterday for a reason. I'm confident that we are going to continue working. This is not going to be the last time you're going to see me. We're going to have a lot of other projects and initiatives working together. Things are changing, like I said yesterday. The rate of change has accelerated dramatically, and that's going to continue. We're going to see changes from the state. We're going to see a lot more partnerships. And there's no other better place than I'll be positioned to work together with Laredo than in the Valley on South Texas initiatives that are going to help Laredo and the entire South Texas region. So I guarantee you, you're going to be seeing a lot more of me for other venture and projects. I definitely would need your expertise from when it comes to healthcare, and then we can work together when it comes to also on the other areas from manufacturing to transportation. That we have a lot ahead of us. It's incredible work. So I think this is going to be a win-win for all of us. With that said, I want to again thank you everybody for everything that you've done. Appreciate it.
Madam Chair, if I may.
Chair recognizes Mr. Judge Martinez.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. I honestly don't know what crystal ball you saw when you came to the presidency of this institution, Dr. Solis. But let me bring this point. I personally went with Dr. Maldonado to visit a facility that had a tremendous amount of incredible equipment dealing with the oil and gas program. I don't mind telling you, and I know, of course, our chair's brother went along with me and Dr. Maldonado, all right, because he was also involved with the oil and gas program. And I'm talking about Orlando Cepeda, who oversaw the engineering in the oil and gas program that at the time the Eagle Ford Shale was at its peak, okay? And the equipment that we saw, it was obviously quite impressive, and it basically required a considerable amount of investment, of which part of that original bond issue was going to be used for that facility that was going to be built here in this campus, Dr. Solis. And again, I honestly commend you. I don't know what was it that you saw in that crystal ball of yours that you in effect said we're going to reallocate and not consider the possibility of building that particular project, actually, which again, it was going to require a considerable amount of investment. I'm talking about a multi-million dollar investment. And you, all of us, of course, now know exactly the situation, okay? Can you imagine if that had not been the case, we would have had a facility with all of that equipment completely dead in our campus. And yet, here we had ability of forecasting and reallocation of some of those funds, multi-million dollar investment, that right now it would have been sad for us to actually see that. But in the process, of course, we now have seen your impressive and incredible investment that has been done on your relocation, and in particular the library that have taken a considerably different attitude, considerably different approach, and of course it has become a major spot for many of our students in there, particularly now even more so because of our the use of all of us the cellular phones that are constantly dealing with it. But again, Dr. Solis, I certainly want to commend you, and I know that you would be a tremendous success over at the South Texas College, and we certainly wish you the very, very best, and we're here to give you the support should you ever need it. We're here to give you the help. We're also are here to help each other out, and there's no reason why we should not be able to leverage the resources between what you will have and what we now have here between these two institutions.
Thank you, Judge.
We wish you the very best.
Thank you for your comments, and it was this board that also had the vision. You hired me because I made it very clear that I was a visionary, but more importantly, I was resourceful. And that's when I was able to forecast a project that were not necessary. There was other ones as well, Student Union Building and others, but this board immediately, unequivocally supported that to change and reallocate those funds. So I'm really in debt to this board to allowing that to happen immediately and put the resources into a different use. Times change, and I'd like to keep on saying 2 years from now, it's gonna be other projects that might change or come up that that's why we've been very diligent, this board, in saving and keeping those monies for the right projects, and because things change so fast. And I know these projects were set up back in 14, 15, that was when they were envisioned, from the library to the expansion of MFA to the student union to the oil and gas, on and on. But those were projects that at that time possibly made sense. But when I came in 16, things changed so fast that I'm glad this board was supported that. And again, things will change not even in 2 years, it'll be less than that. And that's from having a very strong, supportive, visionary, and understanding board. And I'm very grateful for that this board allowed these things to happen. And in summary, I don't want to be repetitive, but again, I'm grateful for all of you, what you've done, the administration and the board, in allowing me to work accordingly. And as I mentioned, yes, we will be partnering in other projects. I'm very confident we will. And I'm glad we're gonna have a very good relationship, Loretto College and the large area of the Rio Grande Valley, because I'll have a bigger impact of a larger demographics that, from what I learned here, like I made it very clear a month ago when I made my announcement, that I'm taking what I learned here down there, and they know it and they recognize it, because Loretto College has been an exemplary institution statewide. So I'm indebted to Loretto College for allowing that to happen. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? So the next item that we have a presentation, 2%, to our college president, Dr. Ricardo Solis.
Yep. You can.
Mr. Gonzalez.
Thank you, Madam Chair, members of the board, and Dr. Solis. This memento comes on behalf of the Loretto College Alumni and Friends Association, but it's truly an appreciation for all that you've done for the college, and I'll just read it. It says, with our greatest appreciation and recognition for your years of visionary guidance, exceptional leadership, and unconditional commitment to Loretto College and the Loretto community, Dr. Ricardo J. Solis, Loretto College President, 2016 to 2021. Sir, this is for you.
Right back. got up and he left. I've never seen the man before. And then after I was finishing, real quickly, 10 minutes later, he shows up with his brother, an older man. And they lived just down the street from here. And they said they brought a little pin, and they had my name on it. And they said, we went in, you can tell they were very humble to him. And they said, this is what all we could afford. But they said, this is for you. We wanted to take it to your office because our children and our grandkids came here. We were not able to afford it back then, back in the 50s. But we were so glad that they did. And they remember that, I know that through the foundation, we give a lot of money to help. They said, no, they called you and you immediately came up with $500 immediately and helped our grandkids without even knowing it. So, and then we've seen the transformation to colleges that it, we are so proud that every time we go and to see the colors, the grounds, he said, we feel so great. And in fact, one of them is taking classes here in the Dole. And he said, I've seen you over there, so I'll be one. So this is what we have to give you this. And now that for me was everything. That was a touch of gratitude and appreciation coming from a very humble beginning, family that lived on the street here. And that for me said everything.
That's this right.
Is about the college, mm-hmm. the impact that we have on people.
Mm-hmm.
So again, this symbolizes that. And I thank you for this. It means a lot to me. And again, I'm not leaving. I'm just going to be down the street.
Well, thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. Chair recognizes Mrs. Ramos.
Dr. Solis, on behalf of the Alumni Association and also the Board of Trustees, it's a little token of appreciation, but for the years, I know that the idea sprung when you came on board about forming the association, and I know I was after you and I was trying to get it done, and we got several people that were on board, and you know, and so we were very fortunate that we were able to start that, and that's an accolade that I think that we'll remember forever. We've had associations before, but we just brought it back to life, and we created it from the bottom, and so we all worked together really hard to make sure that the association and friends continues to flourish and grow and work hand in hand with the foundation. So we're very appreciative of the work that you did for us and that you did with us also, because we sponsored a lot of things that we wouldn't have sponsored before, like assisting the Princess Pocahontas, also, you know, doing the recognition for the LC Stars, the ceremony that we did to recognize some alumni that had been, and then after that we didn't do it because of the pandemic, but. We do acknowledge the fact that we worked hand in hand with you to establish the Alumni Association, and it's not going to go away. It's going to keep growing and growing, but we're very fortunate that you allowed us really to bring it back to life here, because it's going to be a very important association for the rest of the community and also for the friends that would like to create partnerships with our college. So we're very fortunate, and on behalf of the Laredo College Alumni Association and friends and the Laredo College Board of Trustees, we thank you for your years of service to our college. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
May we take a picture?
Yes. We're gonna go ahead and take a picture.
I was gonna finish.
Okay, yeah.
Let me go ahead and finish the agenda and then we'll take the picture. Is that okay? So the next thing is just a reminder. This will be the last Zoom meeting for board members. Going forward, meetings will be in person or by telephone. Public Zoom meetings will continue. That is not gonna change. But as far as the board members, just a reminder. So with that, our next meeting is, we have one Thursday, July 1st at 4 p.m. is a special Board of Trustees meeting. Then we have another one Thursday, July 29th at 6 p.m. and that will be our regular Board of Trustees meeting. So I have a motion for adjournment.
So
moved by Dr. Carranza.
Second.
And second by Mrs. Ramos. Meeting adjourned. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.